All right, so now how do I add a filter for year and month here? I want to have this selection here on top left, right? So how do I do it? I mean, I can add my year and my month into the filter of my pivot table here. So the year and the month. Okay, maybe first year, then month. Okay, and now, of course, I can filter it here like that. But I want this, right, filter to be actually here on top left. So how do I do this? Okay, so let me show you one trick. What I'll do is I will now copy and paste. Just copy, paste my little pivot table here. And this time I will just use the filter area. Okay, I don't need the data. I have the data here, but here I just need a filter, and then I'll move this filter to my dashboard page. All right, so that's why I'll just remove everything else from this pivot table. So basically I have like a miniature pivot table here with only filters. Okay, so what I'll do now is I'll just cut this, move it here on top like this. Okay, so now I have my pivot table that only consists of my filters. But of course, now this is a copy of a pivot table. It will not change the values in my pivot table here, right? So you see, if I now change it to my next month, here I still have May values. All right, so of course this is not working, but I would somehow need to synchronize those two pivot tables, right? Make sure that this filter actually filters this pivot table. How do you do that? The answer is very simple. You can click on any pivot table, either this one or this one. And by the way, I also recommend one thing quite strongly, okay? Every pivot table that you have, and basically every object in Excel, when you're building your dashboards and reports in Excel, make sure that you give them, you know, nice names, legible names that people will understand, that basically you will understand, you know, after a couple of months when you will open your beautiful dashboards, and then, you know, so that you'll understand what is what. So let me just rename this to like my... all this month year filter, right? And this would be my, instead of pivot table one, this will be my APIs, maybe like that. All right, by the way, the Zebra BI visual is now connected to this pivot table, and because I have renamed this pivot table, I just need to check this. So see here, because my Zebra BI table is connected to this pivot table, you have the data source here and it's listed pivot table one. Okay, so this is still the old name, right? Unfortunately, Excel does not like send the rename events to other objects. So if you do this later on, you know, make sure that you actually have your objects connected to the right pivot table. All right, so, but to come back to my trick, okay, how do I now synchronize those two pivot tables through or via the slicer? Okay, so click on one pivot table, go to insert and slicer. All right, now what Excel will present, it'll present all the data fields that you have available, potentially available for your pivot tables. Okay, so this is not just you know, the month, the year, and the KPIs or account data field that I have here in my pivot table, or not just month and year from this little pivot table here, but you actually see all the underlying data fields, all right? Because pivot tables in Excel they have a thing called pivot table cache. All right, when you inserted the pivot table in the background, Excel actually has all the data fields that it found in your source data, right? And you can actually use any of them, okay? But in my case, I will use the year and I'll use the month, okay? And I'll just simply insert year and month slicer. All right, now let's check out what's happening now. So now I have a slicer for my month. If I click on, and this, I still have May and June here, so I click on March. Okay, because I inserted my slicer from this pivot table, this slicer now controls this pivot table. And if I move it to August here, okay, my slicer has synchronized, has synced, okay? So, but this pivot table hasn't synced to this value, right? So that's why we will right-click on the slicer, go to Report Connections. All right. And now you will see a list of all the pivot tables in the whole workbook that you have. And you will just simply tick the pivot tables that you want this slicer to control. Okay. So I need my month year filter to change and my KPIs pivot table. So this is this one. When I do this, all right, now everything is synced. Okay, so basically the slicer, you can just sort of think about the slicer as the synchronizer of multiple pivot tables, which is really nice. And this does not work only within one worksheet. Okay, this works across the whole report. Okay, so we'll get to that a little bit later. Okay, so now let's check this. May, June, you see, it doesn't really matter where I change the slicer. Now I'll move it back to June. And it's June here, everything has changed. So this is the first like technique that you can use to synchronize your data. And also here, right? So I have year 2019. And here I have 2022. So also with the years, I need to set my report connections. Make sure that the year slicer actually also filters this pivot table. And yeah, then I already have some pivot tables for the next worksheets here. Okay, we'll use them later on. All right, now this is set up. Now this also works 2000. Like that. Okay, good. So this was the first, very first technique. Meanwhile, you have seen that my the area of my report here has changed a little bit. It's not anymore the size of it. It's not anymore the same as my rectangle here. This is because this pivot table that I added here has actually changed. Automatically changed the sizes of the fields, right? Like this or like this. Okay, and when pivot table refreshes, it by default changes the width of the columns, okay? Which is something that you probably do not want in a page here, right? You don't want this pivot table to change your dimensions of your report, right? So that's why, you can just right-click, go to pivot table options, and then you have a couple of things that I typically set. So the first one would be this one, right? So this is the auto-fit column width on update, right? So just disable this, okay? And now from now on, whatever happens, this column and this column will just stay exactly the same no matter what happens with your pivot table, okay? It will not change the dimensions of your report, Okay.